Nazeistra's devotion is one of the best sidearm in the game. As you can see, it has a decent firearm attack damage, critical hit rate, critical hit damage, and weak point damage. I used this weapon against elites, void enemy commanders, and void intercept battle bosses. This weapon got buffed in patch 1.0.5. Its critical hit rate got an increase from 36% to 45%, and its critical hit damage from 2 times to 2.25 times. This weapon has a decent weak point damage of 1.7 times. This weapon also has a very unique ability. At level 1, this weapon shreds the target's defense by 10% and at level 4 by 30%. You can also hit your ally and restore their shields, but I have never done that because I don't think it is worth it. Let's start with the weapon options. I opted for bonus firearm attack versus Colossus for boss fights, firearm critical hit damage 20.3%, firearm critical hit rate 11.4%, and firearm attack 12.1%. For the firearm critical hit damage, I will not reroll it to gold as the max critical hit damage is 21.5% and I have 20.3%. The 1.2% difference is really not that much and I don't want to gamble a lot of fine adjustment control access, which is very expensive and it takes a very long time to craft. You can also replace Colossus damage into weak point damage if you can get it. Nazeistra's devotion is a burst damage type, so targets that are weak to burst damage type will take a significant amount of damage. As you can see here, I'm dealing at least 1 million damage on headshots on targets that are weak to burst type damage, and as for targets that are of a different type, I only deal around 400k plus damage. For the module socket, I spent 8 crystallization catalyst and 1 energy activator. For the damage modules, I'm using action and reaction and rifling reinforcement, increasing firearm attack by 93%. For the critical hit rate, I'm using edging shot and better insight, increasing the critical hit rate by 64%. The base critical hit rate of this weapon is 45%. Using the two critical modules increases the base critical hit rate from 45% to 73.8%. For all of those who doesn't know, Valby's Transcendent module Supply Moisture adds a flat firearm critical hit rate of 20%, making Nazeistra's devotion total critical hit rate into 93.8%, which makes this weapon insane when it comes to damage. For the critical hit damage, this weapon comes with a base critical hit damage of 2.25 times. Adding concentration priority and better concentration adds 79.8% to the critical hit damage, increasing the base from 2.25 times to 4.045 times. I added fire rate up, increasing the fire rate by 25%, increasing it from 150 to 199. I also added a cerulean socket for expand weapon charge or recycling genius. I usually use expand weapon charge for boss fights or commanders, and I use recycling genius for all around content. Using recycling genius makes the weapon reload smoother, but most of the time I just use expand weapon charge for more bullets. Then I added weak point sight, increasing weak point damage by 35%. The base weak point damage is 1.7 times, increasing it to 2.295 times. For the last module socket, there are a few choices that I can recommend. You can change the blank socket into a malachite and add weak point expansion, further increasing weak point damage. But I don't really like the cooldown of the module. Also, weak point damage forces you to aim for weak spots or go for headshots, which is realistically not a thing that I can do all the time. There are times where I do other content such as doing infiltration missions or grinding some materials, and I just don't want to aim for the heads of my target. So for the last socket, I added a bullet improvement module depending on my target. If the target is weak to electric, I use electric enhancement. If the target is weak to cold, then I use a chill enhancement, and so on and so forth. Now, you have to make a decision whether you are going for weak point expansion or just go for a cheap bullet enhancement. For me, I am totally fine using a level 4 bullet improvement module, and this also saves you 1 crystallization catalyst and 3 million gold. But if you want to maximize your damage, then go for weak point expansion as it will significantly increase your damage every 5 seconds. If you don't like to add weak point expansion or use any bullet enhancement, you can use Focus Fire level 4. This module is cheap and will increase your weak point damage by 15% and critical hit damage by 4%. To be honest, I don't really like the yellow modules or the special modules such as weak point expansion because of its cooldown. It feels so gimmicky, and I do understand the significant damage increase these modules provide. It's just that I want a consistent build that doesn't rely on damage increase every 5 seconds or 10 seconds. I wish the developers changed the sockets of the different bullet improvement modules into the same socket so that we can fully utilize all the sockets of each weapon, or provide us with a special consumable that can equip any type of socket and at the same time half the capacity cost of a module. All in all, the Nazeistra's devotion is one hell of a weapon. It has one of the best unique ability in the game, its damage is pretty good, it has a decent critical hit rate and critical hit damage, and it has a very nice weak point damage. This weapon is a very good weapon when it comes to elite commanders and boss fights. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.